Hi, I'm Ezekiel Dasho, and I'm going to draw this snow leopard. Just going to dive right into it. For those of you who have been following me on my other videos, welcome back. And for people who are new, welcome. This is going to be a pretty rough sketch, and I know I say that a lot, but to do something in this fine detail would do something like this in super fine detail would take a lot of time. And the video would be very, very long to have it be unedited. I might do something like that one day, but for now, I just saw this picture and wanted to give it a go. So I'm going to start with the head here. I've got the ear here. And is sort of the cheekbone. And the general principle of what I'm doing is just blocking things onto the paper, getting the general shapes drawn in. This will be the nose here. Top of the angles like that. I'm gonna try to keep moving pretty fast rather than getting bogged down today. Hopefully it'll still be useful and so it's got this little chin here. Okay, so it's the ridge of the nose going up, kind of leading into the eye. And he's got this sort of just a little bit of a saucy, scowly look going on there. And the bottom of the eye is pretty round. It's bordered by that dark black inner eye lid. And he's kind of got the comic book style determined brow. It's pretty strong brow. Here. Now to gauge where that goes, I'm kind of parallel to the nose, there's this sort of curve that kind of follows it around here, so you know where to start drawing in the eye there. The eyes aren't as, I guess, like a house cat has the narrow slits for pupils, and that's not coming through as much in this picture. Maybe it's because he's kind of looking, his head is tilted down and he's looking sort of forward, so you don't really see it, but not quite as pronounced of a cat eye shape there. Okay, so the brow leads up into this, kind of just draw line of the center line of the head, and there'll be some, as you can see in the picture, there's quite a bit of spots and pattern on the coat there with fur. So it makes it pretty easy if you're just loosely sketching in the details to, correct. And if you're not happy with where certain line went or whatever, a certain bit of shading went, don't worry about it too much. It'll, as the drawing comes together, it'll be easy to form into the shape that you're looking for. See here, something like this. And then the sideburns or the cheek, the shape of this cheek here is sort of plus G and kind of comes out like this. There's this almost straight line here, angling up there, another one here, and then rounded back into the ear there. On this side, you kind of see his cheek bone a little bit, but there is a little bit of this lighter sideburn sort of cheek shape. And not too much up, halfway up the ear, maybe. See the arch of his back coming up. Or her, I guess it looks like a him. And then a little bit past the ear and around, and go off the page a little bit. And coming down, his legs are down there, so. No, I like this part because there's a lot of fur and it just lets you kind of shade it on to the paper without worrying about it too much. And let's go do a little bit more of his back. It's sort of foreshortened and it kind of gets a little bit out of focus as it goes. I'm not going to worry about that too much. I just wanted to get the general shape in there a little bit. And his tail's back there too. So this is kind of giving us the general idea and how things are going to lay in there as we add the detail. Well, let's go ahead and add a little more detail and then we'll just kind of put some time into the details on the face here, and the rest of the details will kind of just fade into the background a little bit. Curves under the eye, pretty smooth. Very, beautiful, sleek curves there. And the pupil's definitely dark. Well, maybe as black, or if not, a little darker than the eyelids. And here, just being careful to just sort of draw what we see. I'm not trying to change anything. I am trying to represent as faithfully as I can what I see. And, my inability to do that is going to give the picture some character. So, I'm doing the best I can, and it's not going to be a photograph. It's not going to be absolutely accurate with, like a laser beam or anything. And that's all right. not trying to add anything as much as I'm trying to just be as faithful to objective reality as I can here. And then there are certain points where maybe toward the end, you know, I would want to accentuate something. But that's more about trying to make it look as real as possible, and not necessarily about like trying to imbue it with, you know, a certain style or look or anything like that. Here, that's pretty dark. So for those of you who have watched other videos of mine, this is going to be sort of old hat at this point, but just, you know, we've got things blocked in and we're at that point where we want to darken things up a little bit and just identify the places in the picture that need more darkness and stuff as we go. If you watched the video that I made about the kitten, then similar to the kitten, the whiskers kind of can be, you can approach that in a couple of different ways. Like if I was going to, you know, work on making this a photorealistic drawing, I could, you know, draw the whole picture in and then use an electric eraser or something, or a kneading eraser on the pencil or on the white hair, or that'd be one way. Or I could very lightly sketch them in with a harder lead, like not sketch them, but draw them in. So you'd have a very fine line that's in a very different quality of lead, and then go and just color around them, work around them. Similar to if you were doing like a photorealistic beard or anything where you have white hair. You can just put the time in and work, you know, around each detail so that it looks white. That's not really what I'm about right now, but that would be definitely a cool way to approach it if you were really interested in putting a lot of time into developing a, you know, a very realistic image. There are these areas here closer to the chest hair where, you know, like this would be a good place where I could kind of accentuate things a little bit. But basically, I'm going to get the sharp side of my lead, pencil lead here, and draw some of the shade in some of the spots and the patterns. And then when I get into this area with the white fur, go ahead and see if I can show that. So that we're kind of defining some of that white fur there. It's a little bit lighter, and then this like light chest hair area is just a good place to sort of see where, you know, how the shapes are going, the clumps of fur or whatever, and then just choosing one and then shading it in and then kind of repeating from there, just giving it the sense of like the direction. The shading can help a lot with just giving the sense of the direction of the clumps of fur and stuff. Like right now, I'm not going to be super concerned about each individual hair, just kind of the impression, because I want this to look kind of like a drawing and not like a photograph. It's kind of a paradoxical line, because you want it, you know, you want to be as true and faithful to the details as you can, but you don't want to get too bogged down in the details that you're, you know, drawing each individual hair, or, you know, and in some places you might want to draw an individual hair to just give that part of your picture as that the look that you want. It's sort of a just a balance that every artist strikes when they are drawing or painting or whatever. Like this pattern on the top, it's kind of bewildering, and it would take a little bit of studying. I mean, it's kind of evolved over the eons to provide camouflage, but also to just bewilder the eye and the senses, so that, like, if you ever did come within range of this thing in the wild, it'd be hard to see. And then even once you did see it, your eye would have a hard time understanding what it was seeing. So it's the camouflage, but it's also like the surprise factor, So here I want to bring, this is a place that I definitely want to darken things up a bit, because it is darker in the picture, and on my picture right now it's not, or in the photograph it's darker, and on my photograph there's not enough contrast between this back leg area, or the front leg area, and the cheek. There's just so many places where the lines are interrupted by the spots, and that definitely you can see as you're looking at it how that would help it, just help the snow leopard be hard to see accurately, especially when it was like there were light and shadows on it, and all sorts of stuff that in the wild would make it very tough for a prey to understand exactly where it was when it got close to it. For this part here, I'm gonna be pretty and play it a little fast and loose to keep it moving along here. This lighter spot here, just going to go ahead and hit that whole spot real quick. Let's do this front leg detail here. It's fun once you get into the spots and your part of your pencil, if you've been shading like I have for the majority of the drawing, part of it's really flat and great for making shapes like this. It's just like naturally just so fun and easy to get that onto the paper. And I'm gonna keep the hair on the cheek and chin pretty white, and then get the face to stand out a little bit using the contrast of the leg behind it. So rather than try to draw that in, I'm going to take advantage of this big black spot on the fur right here. That'll give a lot of opportunity for contrast and a lot of like little opportunities to do some of this action too, to make it look sharper and stuff. So like really looking for those places where we can darken it up and have it look natural. Like over here, there's this kind of black spot here. They're definitely helpful, you know, they're sort of like points of purchase as you're climbing a wall. You see one and you want to latch onto it and darken it up so that you can see where the contrast nearby is, and it will help you define everything else around it. So it's like I don't want to draw any hard lines except for maybe around his eyes and, you know, these like super dark spots like on the mouth. The lip is pretty dark. And even on the other part of the lip, it's much lighter. I want to get the shapes defined by the shadows on the shapes around them, not defined by lines that I'm drawing. And some of this area, it's easy just to use that flat edge on the pencil and just very, very lightly add some of that the tone into those parts of the fur that are let's see, here's a good example under the eye a little bit. It's a little darker here. And so there's this place in the fur that's created that looks a little lighter under his eye. And then similarly, but a little less pronounced under the ear here. And then there's this tuft of relatively bright fur. It looks pretty bright compared to everything around it. What's happened as I've been drawing is the direction of the shading has started to create this sort of look of motion, which in some places works, and in some places I don't think it does work as much. So in those places where it looks a little too directional, or like the shading is imbuing it with too much of a sense of movement that it doesn't actually have in the picture, I can just go back over them lightly with the very flat edge. And so, like for this place, so far the lines are all in this direction, and I'm just gonna lightly go over them a little bit in certain places to sort of break up that look of motion a little bit, so that it's not so one direction. And you know, some it does depend on like just your personal preference and what you're doing at the time. I mean, I wouldn't categorically say to do it everything one way all the time or anything like that. It's just what I happen to be doing right now. But I think it's natural for us as we're shading to, you know, have everything shaded in a way. Like for me, it's just comfortable to shade right left at this angle right now because of how I'm sitting and how my paper's positioned and stuff. And so if I'm not careful, everything starts to look like it's heading in that direction, kind of. And I just want to be mindful of that so that I'm not creating an image that just looks too monotone or mono directional. Let's give them some more darkness here. I think that it's in the picture, and I haven't quite gotten capture that yet in this picture, but there is quite a bit of darkness on the leg there, and then these tufts of fur kind of going out this way. And the shape of these, I mean, these are spots back here, but the fur is obscuring it in some places, so you want to have them at the right angle, and the picture has all the information we need, so we can just kind of glean it from that. It's not like to do too much guessing, but like I said, I'm not going to break out like the magnifying glass and the ruler or anything. A lot of it's just getting the feel of things in the right place. And his eye here could use some more spots. Going up like that. There's this area here that's definitely a little darker than the rest of the top of the head. And this area on the back that's quite a bit darker. Even has some spots back here that are kind of angled away a little bit. Get the ear in there. Now the ear hair here is give me a little bit of a challenge. It's pretty bright and I want to have it show, so I'm going to need to darken up the space behind it pretty much with urn, but not too much. So I'm going to go looking for where the spots are back there. And oh, it's coming through. It's coming through pretty nicely. Okay, so let's finish up with the face here, and then got some spots kind of going this way, and the top, the angle's kind of like this with the fur. So now that I'm shading, I'm just kind of being sensitive to that angle, which way the fur is going, and it does curve as it goes, so this isn't so much an issue where I want to draw the hairs. This is more of an issue of I want to get the shade of the area correct compared to the areas around it, and then I do want to like add the sense of the direction of the hair there, but it's like not, you know, so that's why I'm going in that direction, but I'm not going in that direction to draw the hair, so it's more of just like a shading move than it is a drawing move there. Kind of, you've got the general shape of the hair there, and then you're just kind of shading it in the color that you want. Shadowing in his eyes there. And definitely darker black. And again on the other side, you know, these should be basically the same. So if you change the depth of the black on one of the ones, you're gonna wanna switch it for the, or you're gonna wanna do likewise on the other side, or it's gonna look weird. And this is pretty much gonna wrap it up for this picture. I'll leave it a little bit unfinished. See how long it's going, and then we'll should probably just, I've got these spots here that are totally white, and I want to definitely give those at least a little something something, and same with the rest of the head here. It's like there are parts of it that are lighter than others, and just getting through very lightly and giving it that extra. So I want to get the hair on his cheeks and chin to move in the way that they are in the picture. And so if I do, what I'm going to do is come in from this side, the inward, and similar to how we did up here with this spot. about the whiskers right now. Darken the eyes a little bit more. Right, so that's basically the process, and doing that you could, you know, extend that all the way into the back of the leopard and everything like that. Hope this was useful. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again real soon.